Okay, so now we're going to make the eye, and the eye has a bit of a different shape to it, and some of it is stitching, and some of it is just stretching with your fingers. So here I've started one of the eyes here, and I followed the pattern, magic circle with 6 stitches in it, then row 2, I put 2 single crochets in each stitch, and now I'm on to row 3, and I put 1 single crochet in the first 4 stitches. So now I'm going to put 3 single crochets into the next stitch. So that's just 1 single crochet 3 times into the same stitch. So you go 1, back into the same hole you were just in, 2, and then back in the same hole again, 4, 3. And there you have 3 single crochets into 1 stitch. And the one thing to watch out for is when you do put 3 single crochets in, there sometimes is a tendency for that, for those crochets to bulge over into the next stitch. So just stretch it out and make sure that you're going into the right stitch for your next crochet. And the other thing I want to mention is the very last stitch of row 4, it calls for a slip stitch into the next stitch, and that is the last thing we're going to do in that row. So a slip stitch is just going in to the next stitch as you normally would, grab some yarn, and instead of yarning over, just continue to pull that loop through. And there you have slip stitched. And then you can finish off as normal. And when you do finish off, leave a good sized tail for sewing. So now we're ready to put the eyes on, and I'm just going to stretch it out a little bit with my fingers so I get the right shape that I want. And we're going to place these a little bit on the high side, I think about 9 rings down. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So just underneath that 9th ring, place the eye. And I like to stuff from the top down on these little pieces. So sew around this way, and then come up and we'll leave a little gap, and then we'll I'll come back and I'll show you how I stuff that. And real quickly, it's hard to sew these little pieces on if you try to get the stitches right close to each other. So what I like to do is I just go close to the edge, put my crochet needle in, and come up somewhere away from the spot I went in. So I'll go back in just underneath that edge there and come up on the edge over here. And don't pull so tightly that you alter the shape of the eye. So I'm just going to keep going around like that until I have a small gap left. So there, I'm sew it up all the way around, and I have a small gap, and I'm just going to stuff a little bit of stuffing in there. Remember to shape as you stuff. Okay, so now we have our stuffing in there, we can close up the gap. Okay, so for the eyelid, we're going to chain 8, and starting with the second chain from the hook, there's your first chain, and we want to go into the second chain first. We're going to put 1 single crochet in the next 2 stitches. And then we're going to put a double crochet in the next 5 chains. So double crochet is yarn over before you go into your chain. Grab some yarn. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Grab some yarn, pull it through the first 2 loops, and there you have 2 loops on your hook again. Grab some more yarn and pull it through those 2 loops. So yarn over, go into your chain, grab some yarn, pull it through those first 2 loops, grab some yarn, and pull it through the last two loops. So this is what your finished eyelid looks like, and there's a pointed edge and a flat edge. So when you put the eyelid over the eye, the flat edge goes in this area and the pointed edge goes down here. So I'll just show you the first couple of stitches here. So we're going to put the corner right so it's butting up with this other eyelid, and we're going to come out on the side, and that's where we're going to put our stitch through the pointed end. So there we have it held in place there. So they're both eyelids are on. So now for the edging on the bottom of the eye, I just go into the corner, one of the corners here. Here, let's start over here. And come up in the corner of this other edge of eye here. I'm going to wrap that tail there. And I'm going to bring my crochet hook just underneath there and come out somewhere else. And pull that tight. Now I'm going to take this other tail and I'm going to go up out where this other, the same hole where this other tail is, and I'm going to knot these off. And I'm going to go back in and up through the middle here. Now I can cut them free. So this is what your nose should look like before it's stuffed. Just follow the pattern. And then once you finish it off, cut it free and leave a long tail for sewing. And now we're going to weave in and out on the top edge of the nose. So just in and out of those stitches. Now we can stuff the nose. Just take a little bit of stuffing and use your stuffing stick. Now pull the nose closed. Now it's ready to be sewn in place. And when you put the nose on, just make sure that that circle part there, that's actually the magic circle, what we started with, is center. Front and center, otherwise it'll make the nose look a little bit off. Now go back in that same hole you just came out of and come up just underneath the nose and grab one of those edge stitches. So now you can continue doing that until you feel the nose is firmly in place. Okay, so for the pupils, just cut some black felt in the shape that you want, and I glued, hot glued mine in place. And for the mouth, I haven't quite decided what I want done with the mouth yet. So it's a good idea to try out different looks and see what you think is best. Let's make the leaf part. And I went ahead and I started it, and I finished row 4. And I have 18 stitches around. And right from this point, I'm going to chain 3. And then I'm going to put a single crochet, starting with the second chain from the hook. So 1. I have squeaky yarn. And 2. And now I'm going to crochet right into the next stitch from where I started the chain. So there's one leaf. And now we're going to chain 2 and just single crochet into the next stitch. Now start all over, chain three, and single crochet, starting with the second chain from the hook. And then crochet into the next stitch. Chain two. So we're going to repeat that all the way around till we get to the end. So there, I'm done my leaf, and now I'm going to add a stem. And for the stem, I just chain three, and I'm going to attach it here. Now to get rid of this tail here, you can't just cut that because it will eventually unravel. So what I like to do is just weave it down the chain, and don't pull it too tight because it will scrunch up your, and now your stem. The tail is at the bottom, so I'm going to bring that through the middle as well, and don't pull it too tight, like I say, because it will, because you weaved it through here, it's going to pull that stem down. So now you're just going to knot these off. There you go. So now you can put it on top. So you can either sew that in place or hot glue it. So that's the end of this tutorial. So anyway, I hope you guys had fun, and I hope that you got your tomato made. And if you did, please post pictures on my Facebook wall, Amigurumi Freely. I would love to see them. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you real soon.